drive.
Thank you.
I'll see you later.
Oh, I'll see you later. Thanks. Hello.
Hello.
You want a flag?
Yeah, go for
Thanks.
It. Thank you.
Cheers.
You got
law in your hands.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Oh, yeah, you got your hands full. You want a flag? Do you want a flag? Thank you.
It's our fourth day of strike action, and it's picking up momentum. You can see there's more people here today because the local council have now voted to say they're anti-academy and that parents should have a ballot. And the staff of this school have been asking for that. We want a staff ballot and a parent ballot. And we want to know, have school got a mandate to move us into academisation? We want to argue our case and we want parents to have a chance to express their view.
The councillors are saying, yeah, the policy has changed, and now we're saying back to them, great, now let's get on and implement it. So that's the next fight. Get the council to implement its own new policy of opposing academisation.
We've written to the governors, we've asked for meetings, but so far they've ignored our requests. But we're hoping that they'll get the confidence to realise that the parents support them in keeping this school a locally managed school. We don't need to become an academy to improve. We want to improve this school. It needs to improve, but we don't need to become an academy. An academy would be a blight on the local education service. If we leave the local authority, the other schools are weakened by that. We need to stay together and work together. Serious that can support and the improvement of our school. There isn't just one size fits all, it doesn't. We need to make sure that we find a model for this borough that works. We've got examples of a model in Redbridge, we've got examples in Hackney. Across the country, there are alternatives to academisation that are working. We need to be part of this new movement. It's not a done deal that this is the only way forward for the next 25 years. There are alternatives already emerging, and we mustn't let our school move down in a direction that has already failed. We have to find an alternative, and I'm sure we can.
Our schools are not for sale.
No to academies.
Our schools are not for sale.
No to academies.
I'm not a parent, I don't work in a school, but like the people that are on strike today, I think that education belongs to the community, and that's why everybody has to come down who lives locally to support the education workers that are on strike in Newham. So that's what I've done today.
What do we want?
Fair and balanced.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Fair and balanced.
When do we want it?
Now.
Our concerns about step up, about the counselling services, about pupils in nurture groups being put back into mainstream. There may be good reasons for it. There may be better models. We're professionals. We're quite prepared to suffer. But what we're not happy about is that there's no consultation. Members of staff are not consulted prior to these decisions. We're not encouraged to get involved in making sure that it happens in a good way. And parents have not been informed either. When we look back at that consultation, how many parents came? Some people are saying none. Some people are saying one. How many parents came to that consultation? These parents are saying they didn't know it was happening. If they'd known it was happening, they'd have been there. So clearly there's been something gone wrong with the consultation. And certainly since the summer, when we've seen what's happened in Wakefield, with the 21 schools there, we've seen what's happened in the Isle of Wight, where they've chucked the academies off the island. We've got stories from all around the country telling us that MATs are poorly financed, that they're going again and again and again asking for more money.
My son went to Hornfield. My son didn't learn a different word in Hornfield. He couldn't plan, he couldn't write his name, he couldn't spell. Since he's been here, it's come from here up there. Don't get me wrong, he's never ever going to be a doctor or anything like that. But he will come out knowing his ABC, his counting, he'll know social skills, he will mix with people. he never had that, and now it feels as though they're trying to take that away from him. And I can't live with that. They're making it as if, oh, right, if we bring this big deal up, all the parents will pull them out. Where do we put them? And there is no way I'm going back to the 1940s where people were put in asylums and all these places and forgot about. I'm not doing it. I have fought so hard to get my child into a mainstream school, and everyone's been supported. The TAs, the teachers, the Senko, who is absolutely fantastic, and we are gutted that he's leaving. And yet now we feel like we're being put in a little box and forgot about. We can't do that no more. We need to know that our kids are going to be able to learn. We need to know that our kids are going to feel comfortable and not push that because they don't think that there's, yeah, special needs should be coming to one of these schools. It's not right.
You know, we didn't stand up against this initially. You know, but the more we've heard about it, the more we've realised, and we changed our mind. There is no shame in our governing body and our head teacher changing their mind. Because remember, they'd be changing their mind back to what they originally thought, because they were always anti-academy. So, you know, this is what we need to, this is the message I think that we're trying to get out, and that we keep going.